It's been a complicated and very interesting week here from the Coastal Bend, but we will have hockey here at the American Bank Center. Colin Shuck reporting for Ice Race TV, and it's been difficult and interesting since the Ice Race found out that we had to tear up the ice this week to get us back set for this weekend, moving Friday's game to Sunday afternoon. But from the looks of it right now, the crew here at the American Bank Center, the SMG staff, the Ice Race staff, and all those in the conversion crew will have things set for tonight's game at 7:45. Speaking of tonight's game, the Ice Race coming off of a weekend against the Topeka Roadrunners, splitting the weekend here at home last Thursday and Friday to finish off the season series, winning 5 of 8 against Topeka, something they had never done in their junior franchise history, claiming now 7 wins over the past 6 seasons and 5 of them coming this year. Now this weekend, the Ice Race 16-17-4 with 36 points and now 4th in the South Division. They're still in the playoff position, 6 points ahead of Odessa for that 4th and final playoff spot. And as the season goes, that gap could either get smaller or tighter. And along with that too, each game becomes that much more crucial. Their opponents, the Amarillo Bulls, 8-26-4 this year with 20 points of their own, last out of 6 in the South Division. They're still in the playoff hunt as of right now, but the problem is being 16 points back at the Ice Rays and a playoff spot. These 4 games against Amarillo over the next few weeks will be that much more crucial for both sides on the ice. It'll be a contest of netminders as well. Anton Martinson, picked for the South team in the NAHL Top Prospects Tournament, he'll get the start most likely this weekend for both games. He's been a big factor, and whichever way he's gone, the Bulls have also gone. He's been the heart and soul of this team, on pace already to play 55 out of the 60 games that Amarillo will have scheduled this season if he plays every single game from now up until the rest of the season. On the other side, the Ice Rays have a duo of goaltenders, Graham Hunt also selected to that Team South team, and Dryden McKay saw time in the USHL back in December and January, so with a two-headed tandem back in net, plus Anton Martinson on the other side, it's going to be a matter of who blinks first, and whoever blinks will allow their opponents to gain the advantage over the course of this weekend. Tonight's game will start at 7:45 p.m. here from the American Bank Center, and it's Energy Industry Night, presented by IBEW Local 278, Laguna Wealth Services, M&G Chemicals, and Voestalpine. There'll be a silent auction throughout the course of the evening, and proceeds from that will go directly to CASA of the Coastal Bend. Plus, it's a Caller Times Family 4-Pack Night, meaning you get 4 tickets, 4 hot dogs, and 4 sodas for just $46. Plus, there's a post-game skate afterwards presented by Brazelton Homes, and that leads us to the Sunday matinee at 2:30 p.m. All promotions from Friday do carry over into Sunday, meaning that there'll be dollar beers and sodas all afternoon long, plus another post-game skate presented by Brazelton Homes right after the final whistle. You can get your tickets for both games at Ticketmaster.com, the American Bank Center box office, or by calling the Ice Rays at 361-814-PUCK. That's 361-814-7825. And if you can't make the game, tune in radio side, either on SportsJuice.com or FastHockey.com, joining me 15 minutes prior to the opening faceoff. Once again, I'm Colin Shuck for Ice Rays TV. We hope to see you this weekend, and go Ice Rays!